is watching us now. It's a little intimidating,
but since there's no way to calm down, let's give them something amazing. Let's make them remember.
Using one word, incredible.
Ilondoloze uhambe nami. kalema ikayala mi ilo noloze uhambe nami sumangishilana dawo yami ayikholana mbuso wami awukholana ilo noloze Dawo yami ayikholana mbuso wami awukholana ilondoloze
God, for who you are. You are a good God, and we praise you because you never changed. You are the same yesterday, today, and forever. Father, we ask then that your presence will be in this place, that today, God, will be a blessing, that today, Lord, we can know for truth that you were here to help us. Help us in this graduation service. We ask, God, that those who will be partaking, Lord God, will be on their best behavior, their best professional stance, their best in communicating the truth to these students. Father, we pray that, Lord, you will help us. Remember everything that will be done. We ask, Lord, that your presence will be here. And when it's all said and done, we ask, God, that we will say, it was good for us to be here. So be with us now. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Thank you. Welcome to our graduation ceremony for the year 2021. The most significant event in a student's life is none other than graduation. And since it is the end stage in your education, it brings us a mixture of joy and pain. Joy for reaching your goals and pain for saying goodbye to the people who became a part of your life. It's my privilege and pleasure on behalf of the Roger Clarke High School to welcome you here today, to our distinguished guests, to our school administrators, headed by the chairman of the board, Mr. Eugene Morgan, Mr. G. Lewis, our principal, teachers and staff, our dear parents, fellow graduates, a pleasant afternoon and welcome to the graduation ceremony of the Roger Clarke High School for the year 2021. We are delighted to have you with us today to participate and share in another milestone of the Roger Clarke High School amid the COVID-19 pandemic. Thank you for joining this platform, whether by Wi-Fi, hotspot, or use of data. I thank you all for responding to this cause. Education is a goal we all share and is still pertinent today for the full development of all students to fulfill their God-given potential during this era. Our motto states, perseverance conquers everything, and our mission today is to provide practical steps to assist students so that they can achieve their goal. Our graduation theme for 2021 states, persevered despite the obstacles, forever resilient. Be strong and courageous in your pathways. Do not be afraid or terrified of your new beginnings. In all things, let your light shine. Whether you are a candle in a corner or a lighthouse on a hill, as you continue to persevere towards success, despite the obstacles, and build your resilience as you go on your pathways. Proverbs 3 verse 6 said, he shall direct your path. Each person's pathway is different and unique. No two people ever travel the same road or same path in life. The great comfort that you know is that the Lord will direct your path. When we don't know what to do, He will step into our lives and direct things. We would like to thank those who worked hard in organizing this well-prepared event. Our graduation is even more memorable because of the effort you put in it. Thank you, dear teachers, for the knowledge you have given to these students and all those wonderful lessons you shared with them. Thank you, dear parents, for working hard to give them a good education. We are happy that you are here with us today because of this milestone. And most of all, thank God for all of your blessings. A thought I would like to leave with you in closing. A dream written with a date is a goal. A broken down steps becomes a plan. A plan backed by action makes your dream come true. Graduates, dream big, start small, but most of all, start dreaming. Again, I say welcome, and now extend your arms to the graduating class of 2021.
The school year 2020-21 was certainly a challenging one. The COVID-19 pandemic tested the strength and the perseverance of teachers, students, and parents. It surely is a proud moment for teachers and students and all stakeholders to see Roger Clarke High School's first virtual graduation on YouTube and Facebook. The theme for this year's graduation is Persevered Despite Obstacles, Forever Resilient. 2021 graduating class of Roger Clarke High School, you deserve this moment. You deserve to be here. Take pride in how far you have come and have faith in how far you can go. I salute you all.
Good afternoon. We'll be reading from Timothy 2, verse 47. And it reads, and they shall turn away their eyes from the trust and shall be turned unto fables. But watch thou in all things, endure affliction, do the work of an evangelist, make full proof of the ministry. For I am now ready to be offered, and the times of my departure is at hand. I have fought a good fight. I have finished my course. I have kept the faith. I have fought the good fight. I have finished my course. I have kept the faith. Here ended the reading of God's holy word.
Pray. Good afternoon, everyone, and also the graduating class of 2021. To my 11th age form class, my heart is overwhelmed with sadness, but at the same time, joy, knowing that you have completed your secondary education. I can't believe it is the end of the school year. It has been such a great pleasure working with each and every one of you, watching all of the achievements you have made. As you move to the next step of your journey, I want you to remember to always strive to make all of your dreams come true. I have enjoyed my time with you and wish you all the best luck in your future endeavors. Now I'm going to leave you with a quote from Dr. Martin Luther King. Intelligence plus character, that is the goal of true education, end quote. Your intelligence and character will carry you through your journey of life. All the best, 11th age. Thank you.
Good afternoon. The scripture will be taken from Isaiah 40, verse 26 to 31. Verse 26. Lift up your eyes and look to the heavens. Who created all these? He who brings out the starry hosts, one by one, and calls forth each of them by name. Because of his great power and mighty strength, no one of them is missing. Verse 27. Why do you complain, Jacob? Why do you worry? Why do you say, Israel? My way is hidden from the Lord. My cause is disregarded by my God. Do you not know? Have you not heard? The Lord is everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth. He will not grow tired or weary, and his understanding no one can fathom. He gives strength to the weary and increases the power of the weak. Even youths can grow tired and weary, and young men can stumble and fall. But those who hope in the Lord will renew their strength. They will soar on wings like eagles, and they will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not be faint. Here ends the reading of God's word.
Master of Ceremony, Mr. Mark Anderson, Board Chairman, Mr. Eugene Morgan, Education Officer, Mr. Gregory King, members of the academic, administrative, and auxiliary staff, parents and well-wishers in the virtual space, students, and the most important group, our graduates, good afternoon. To the best of my knowledge, and I do stand corrected, the last time a school year started late, was in 1988 after the onslaught of Hurricane Gilbert. One thing is for sure though, we would have to go back for more than 100 years to remember when the world experienced a global pandemic. The novel coronavirus called COVID-19 has certainly changed our lives in every facet possible. I will not bore you with listing the many ways because we're all living them now. For sure though, these students have persevered. And so I want to pause and personally congratulate you all. The school year 2020-2021, as I alluded to earlier, started on October 5, 2020, 1 month later than scheduled. The year started as the previous school year ended, with classes being held online, as well as via the dissemination of printed materials in the respective communities where our students live. This really was not ideal and had limited success. But nonetheless, our academic staff persevered. Our students remained resilient despite the odds. And here I want to pause and lift my proverbial hat to our academic staff. I feel honored to be working with such a determined, dedicated, and committed set of educators. Teachers, George M. Lewis is proud of you. We were granted the opportunity to resume face-to-face teaching at the start of the second term, that is January 4, 2021, And oh, what a joy that was. Our entire staff welcomed our students, whom we had not seen for almost 10 months. The ancillary staff pulled out all the stops to ensure that the campus was COVID-19 compliant and ready to receive our students. Our admin staff became chief temperature checkers, if I can coin a term, and recorders of names and data at the gate. The task was a monumental one, but they rose to the occasion. They rose to the occasion with dedication like I've never seen before. And so it is with humility that I pause here to say thanks to the admin and the ancillary staff. I honestly, genuinely thank you very much. It is because of your dedication and resilience that today we can celebrate our graduates. It is from you that our graduates learn to be resilient, to be strong, to be, as I coin it, COVID strong. And so while the pandemic continued to rage, you graduates continued to fight because you were determined to complete your high school education. And for that, you must be commended. Mr. Chairman, ladies and gentlemen, this year not only tested our discipline, but it also tested our commitment to education. It tested our commitment to educating the students of Roger Clarke High School. We navigated floodwaters, believe it or not, in order to reach our students. And this was on the initiative of a member of staff, Mrs. Thompson-Swaby, who pitched the idea that we should go out to the communities and reach our students and remind them that we're still here and we still care for them despite the changes in the education landscape, and that we did. We issued care packages to needy students and needy families, led by the Student Services Unit. We offered a shoulder to cry on and extended support to grieving families, led by our counselors. And here I pause to remember those members of our family who transitioned from this life during this school year. We remember Mr. Atkinson, Shalisa Litchmore, and Bran Absalom. May their souls rest in peace and light perpetual shine on them. Indeed, we had other members of our Roger Clarke High School family who lost loved ones as well. We were forced into another break from face-to-face teaching as the pandemic got worse, but we persevered. And then by May, we were permitted to return for one last hurrah. And our senior students who are gathered here today showed determination like never seen before. They came out, they obeyed the protocols, they braved the risk, they were focused. Some naysayers would probably expect that they would just waste time and there'd be persistent disciplinary problems. No. Mr. Aldred, our Dean of Discipline, had very little to do. His report was similar to that of the sport reporter who went to a cricket match and then submitted his report to the editor. Rain, no play. That's how short Mr. Aldridge's report would have been. And so, in closing, graduates, today I salute you. I raise my hat in honor of you. You have been tried. You have been tested. And you have come out victors. I charge you, therefore, go forth now with that same spirit of perseverance and claim your place at the table. Never, never let anyone tell you that you're not strong, because you are COVID-19 strong. You're COVID-19 resilient. And wherever you go, remember Roger Clarke High School. Remember to give back to your school in order to help those who you leave behind. God bless you all. I am your principal, George M. Lewis. I thank you.
Congratulations. You've made it. It's time to celebrate all the hard work that led you to this joyous occasion. As one famous philosopher and politician states, every new beginning comes from some other beginning's end. 11R, it was a pleasure being your form teacher for the past 2 years. Some of you I have known since you were in grade 8. You have proven to be a set of reliable, responsible, real, and resilient set of students. We have had some fun times together, playing games, or whether it was just sitting in the classroom having a wonderful discussion. You have proven to the world and to your parents that you can conquer anything. It was never easy, but you dared not give up, because if you did, you would not have been one step closer to your dreams. I am so proud of you. Congratulations.
A great scholar, Josephson, once said, if the opportunity doesn't knock, build a door. Can you believe it? 5 years ago, we all created and opened doors to the grace pathway of Roger Clarke High School, formerly Balaclava High School. Most of us walk into these halls nervous as we were the first day of primary school. We were the newcomers, freshmen, the lowmen on the tontem pole. But 5 years, we are the quintessential group, leaving the school behind to a whole new crop of students. Greetings, respected chairman, Ministry of Education official, principal, vice principal, members of the academic, administrative, and auxiliary staff, or viewers online, and lastly, my fellow graduates. I am absolutely honored to be standing here representing the graduating class of 2021. On behalf of the graduates, I would like to thank you for joining us on this auspicious occasion. Today, we become Roger Clarke High School graduates. The home of real champions are the creators of tomorrow, bravura doctors, lawyers, teachers, psychologists, musicians, engineers, architects, nurses, electricians, plumbers, and welders. No matter how we got to the Roger Clarke High School few years ago, what is important now is that we all are here today to celebrate our triumphs, our achievements, our victories, as we all embark towards our future goals, both individually and as a school. Let us take a moment and reminisce. Each of us had our own unique experiences at the Roger Clarke High School, a combination of good times and bad times, times of laughter and joy. times of school spirit, and of course, times of last-minute studying for that exam that we forgot was taking place the following morning. So all our teachers from grade 7 to 9 who gave us the foundation we needed to start our journey into upper school, we salute you. We can also attest to all those unforgettable moments that we have experienced with facilitators such as Mr. Larman, Ms. Johnson, Mrs. Reed Periel, Mrs. Boswell Lewis, Mrs. Campbell Parchment, Mr. Belinfanti, Mrs. Mitchell, and our lab technician, Mr. Stevenson. Mr. Larman, whose favorite slang was Shell, which is the imperium power to motivate us every time we completed a mathematics question correctly. Mrs. Johnson, who would always say, "Is it true or false, students? Or guys, time is of the essence." Mrs. Reed Perel would always say, "Students, it is not hard, it is challenging." What a fine way to put it. Mr. Belinfanti, whose worst fear was to be trapped by the rain in the classroom with his biology students. Mrs. Mitchell, who would always have extra classes to keep her students up to par with the content of the syllabus. Mrs. Boswell Lewis, who would ensure that students grasp the concept taught even when they constantly try to lure her away from class objectives to religious discussions. How can I even forget our school mother, Mrs. Campbell Parchment, who would always motivate us when we were agitated, prayed for us, and went beyond the call of duty to help us with assignments, even if it was not related to her subject, information technology. Lastly, the jack of all trades and master of many, Mr. Stevenson, who would always encourage us, prayed for us, offered financial assistance, help us to type and print our assignments. Thank you and blessings to you all as you continue to be the immaculate individuals you are, making Roger Clarke High School a beacon of hope. So my fellow graduates, our graduation ceremony today marked the end of yet another extraordinary chapter in our lives. With this chapter closed, I am certain that many of us are already anxious about starting the next one, because unlike an English book, we cannot skip through the pages of life to see how long or what the next chapter is going to be. We all have our own book of life that has not yet been written. Every day that passes is another page we write in ourselves. Luckily, as Roger Clarke High School graduates, we are given all the paper and ink we need to write our stories. And with the love and support of our families, both biological and adopted, friends and fellow graduates, our stories will become best sellers. Labor omnia vincit. Perseverance conquers everything.
The board chairman, Mr. Usain Morgan, ministry official, distinguished guests, Principal Mr. George Lewis, Vice Principal Mrs. Joan Clarke Farbs, teachers, parents, and fellow graduates. Good afternoon to you all, and thank you for joining us for our virtual graduation. I am honored to represent the graduating class of 2021 as a senior student and proud member of Batch 3 from the sixth form program. Graduation is not an end goal of itself. It is instead part of the larger journey of life. Wherever your future takes you, remember you are a proud product of hard work and resilience. Life is a journey, and all accomplishments we achieve during its course should be taken as a starting point for further achievements. This graduation should serve as a high point, projecting us to the future. Whether we land ourselves a career, focus on a trade, or continue our education at a college or vocational school, we have had so much memorable moments as a class. We remember having communication study class just before school over, while a football match is being held. Everybody have on bag pan bag even before class finish, because everybody want to catch early seat at the rope. Those were days that made our sixth form journey memorable. As we journeyed, there were some teachers that made the journey easy for us. Mrs. Blythe Boswell, who always give us a little treat of snacks whenever she can, and also for giving us the knowledge and understanding. We call her Miss Winnie the Pooh. We remember days when we had food class. We were always late for class, but we always had to fill our water bottles before going, as the heat was not a good thing in that lab. Our teacher, Mrs. Boswell Lewis, we will always remember you as a teacher who have big plans for her students and also the school. The teachers who always go way beyond to make things happen, not to mention where she ensures each student understand before moving on. A big thanks to you, Mrs. Boswell Lewis, for always being a motivator. How can we not mention Mrs. Gray Lewin, who taught us entrepreneurship and tourism? We have learned a lot from you, and we really appreciate all that you have done. Mrs. Atkinson, our Caribbean study teacher, who made the subject fun at first, we didn't like it. We thank you, Miss Johnson, who always ensure she is at school for every class. Thanks for your patience and dedication towards us, Mr. Cole, who made time in ensuring we understand and were able to work out the solution to the most challenging math equation. Thank you, sir. Mrs. Pantan, the IT teacher, who ensured the students understand all the concepts, even we were to be at school, outside of class time. Thank you. Mr. Belinfanti, for helping us to understand the concept in biology and physical education. Thank you. Mrs. Williams Mitchell, our farm teacher and chemistry teacher, who always go the extra mile to facilitate us and ensure we were grasping the concept and following the rules of the school, for always motivating us to be responsible. Thank you, Miss. As our theme suggests, persevere despite the challenges. We had so many, but the most outstanding is COVID-19. For almost two school years, we battled with it, keeping up with data plans, Wi-Fi access, Zoom, and Google Meeting class. Feeling like giving up when we are limited to only WhatsApp classes. In some cases, still having to do our individual assessment for CAPE, but through it all, we have demonstrated that we are forever resilient. To all the staff of Roger Clarke High School, thank you for believing in us and for guiding us graduates as we proceed to the next chapter of our lives. Let us be resilient, let us be conquerors, let us be proud graduates of the noble of this noble institution. God bless you all. To all the staff of Roger Clarke High School, thank you for believing in us and for guiding us. Graduates, we proceed to the next chapter of our lives. Let us be resilient. Let us conquer. Let us be proud graduates of this noble institution. God bless you all. Thank you.
Mr. Principal, as a grade 11 supervisor, I am proud to present to you 42 students of the graduating class of 2021. Jamai Brown. Tylee Bennett. Davis, Alia Costa, Javon McIntosh, Annalisa Brown. Shakara Ellis, Maxwell Duncan,
Demario Peart, Camille Blake, Janoy Small, Devin Blake, Zinia Blackwood, Anisha Bramwell, Kingsley Forbes, Bridget Burnett, Jamil Baker, So Tona Devi. Siobhan Barrett. Tija Lynch. Javante Brown. Rashida McDonnell. Kyle Brown. Tanis McPherson. Romario Griffiths. Anna K. Smith. Austin Rowe. Brittany Cabana. Deshaun Dixon. Shana K. Wesom. Sharisa Rowe. Chanel Samuels. And Onisia Watson. I have presented the grade 11 class of 2021.
Mr. Principal, as the grade 13 year supervisor, I am proud to present to you of the 9 eligible candidates for graduation, 2 candidates for graduation for the class of 2021. Omar Cohen. Tiana Petty. I am proud to have presented to you, Mr. Principal, the 2 eligible candidates for the graduating class of grade 13, 2021.
Good afternoon, all. I am very elated to introduce to you a caring and responsive educator who is committed and dedicated to the various roles and functions she executes on a daily basis. This educator, since 1982, has served the Jamaican education community with early beginnings as a teacher at the Jose Marti Technical High School. She also lectured at the Michael Teachers College before joining the Ministry of Education as an education officer in January 2002. And subsequently assumed the post of Regional Director, Region 5, in 2012. This leader holds a PhD in Educational Administration with research work on the management of teacher performance appraisal and a master's degree in workforce education. Other tertiary level qualifications from the Michael University College and a diploma in educational leadership and management from the University of Alberta, Canada. Despite the demand of her work schedule, she serves on a number of educational boards and committees. Currently, she serves as Jamaica's Technical Delegate for World Skills International, Chair of the Commitment for Teachers Vocational Education, America's Skills, and served as Vice President for International Affairs for Brazil Skills of the Americas. She holds the title of Certified Lean Six Sigma Green Belt and Certified International Coach, for which she demonstrates the requisite competencies. This lover of plants has an impressive commitment to community effort and is an advocate for the children, right? She's married to Reynolds and a mother of three children. Ladies and gentlemen, graduates, I present to you our guest speaker, Dr. Nadine Richmond. I thank you.
Master of Ceremonies, distinguished guests, well-wishers, Chairman of the Board of Management and other members present, Principal Mr. George Lewis, Vice Principal and staff, parents, and of course, our students that I will be speaking to today. It is with a sense of pride that I share in the capacity of keynote speaker at your virtual graduation, extolling the class of 2021. I have a strong feeling that your school will be blessed with the return of many of you as you prepare yourselves to join the sixth form program in one of the three pathways. Am I thinking like you are thinking? Well, I want you to think like that as you make use of options and opportunities at your disposal. Now, whether you go back to secondary level or tertiary institutions, or you go to the world of work, which I don't believe have, you know, much opportunity for you at this time, given your age and stage. But for those who might go to the world of work, it really doesn't matter where you go. Whatever I'm going to say to you will be relevant just the same. I really like to read Maya Angelou's work. It reminds me of strength and resilience. And those are things that all of us really need to practice, as would have been shown to us during the COVID period. Maya Angelou's quote that I'm going to share with you typically sums up that which I want to say. And I draw your attention to this. My mission in life is not merely to survive, but to thrive, and to do so with some passion, some compassion, some humor, and some style. This succinctly sums up what I wish to say to you today as I summarize 3 points. And the first of which, seize the opportunities at your disposal. Certainly, a high percentage of you certainly do not come from rich household. And I say this because the greater percentage of us are not from very rich households. And so the gifts of legacy will never be handed down to those of you who are here who are not from those households. But you are not defined by your economic conditions, meaning the fact that you are from humble beginnings really doesn't say you have to remain there forever. There are opportunities that continue to knock at our doors that we tend not to even notice. Now, students, you are in charge of your destiny, whether you believe it or not. We as adults, we can talk, but we really can't do much that you are supposed to do. In other words, We can't open up that brain and put the sense in there as we usually say. We can inspire, we can motivate and hope that it clicks. Many have built great fortunes, although they never had the legacy. When you listen to some of the rich dudes today, they will tell you where they're coming from, but how an opportunity knocked, and they seize the moment and they become rich men and women of today. But you have to know that what your heart conceives, you can achieve. So if you tell yourself, this is what I want, this is what I'm going to do, no matter what, then you will seize the opportunities that you see because you so want to achieve same. It is therefore dependent on what you believe that you can do. And I'm saying you can do it. You might ask me how, all right? I hear you, how? My answer would be like this. To have you to think about times when you feel so drained and you feel like you just can't go another minute because your energy level is now very low. But something happens. You might get a message that there's an emergency. Something is happening at home that you must come now. It might, you know, it can be anything, but something of importance. You feel all of a sudden a surge of energy that digs deep within, and you are out of there in no time. You are the very person who felt like you couldn't do it just minutes before. It's because you tell yourself that you must and you can, and so you are refueled immediately. Like that. So if you believe it, you can achieve it. There are times when we get so lackadaisical, we couldn't care less, because we wait on things to come falling in our laps, and so we do not notice that it was really an opportunity that was knocking at our door, because we are just not prepared to do that. My advice is for you to seize the opportunities that present themselves, no matter how dumb it seems, and avoid the get rich quick lotto Ponzi schemes that come to replace ideas of hard work and sacrifice as avenues to economic growth and progress. Here is an example. After leaving school, you might find that you are uncertain about what you want to do with yourself. There might just be a garage that you pass, you know, from time to time, but you love cars and you keep staring at the cars. But that's all you do. You find yourself stopping there and staring at the cars because you're attracted to these vehicles. But you never one day thought, you know, I could go in and I could see what the people are doing, how they work on the cars. It might not just remain an attraction for me, but I will be able to actually touch and do and feel and fix and feel good about my achievement. Perhaps the proprietor needs some help. You know, like a young man to pass things, and you begin to pass things until you begin to fix things, and you volunteer or you get a stipend, but now you become confident and you take a bold step towards your future. You stay right there and you move from passing the tools to actually connecting things, using the tools to fix things. Then you find that you are left in charge sometimes. And hello, soon and very soon, you're your own entrepreneur and you could become one of the greatest entrepreneurs. You never know what could happen. So I'm saying to you, you can own your empire by just seizing an opportunity that comes your way. And you do so with every passion in your being, taking advantage of opportunities and chart your course. The second thing I would like to speak to you about is how to avoid self-serving attitude. and move to one of helping others. Don't just think about yourself, students. You're not too young to understand that we live our lives not just for ourselves, but to serve others. You heard Maya Angelou's quote that said you have to have passion and compassion. Maya speaks about serving with not just passion, but compassion. Always extend yourself to help others. And the more you do that, is the more you find that doors of opportunities open for you. You might ask me again, how? How? Because I'm not used to that. This is how I grew up. This is me. But it's about sacrifice for others. It's about making up your mind to do things that you're not accustomed to doing because it is for the good. You're going to shake off some of the labels that you hold on to. And these are not positive labels. These are labels in which you disguise your true self and form. You conceal things that you might not want to come to the fore. But that will not help you to thrive. Remember what Moya said. It's about thriving to be your best self. And one's best self survive with attitudes of selflessness. So even at school, you sometimes ignore your classmates in need. You say nasty things to people that hurt. You're not helping. Sometimes your classmates are laughing and jeering others. And instead of offering love, you join them. And you make that person feel as if he or she has no worth. You never know where that very person you jeered and mocked in school and treat as if he has no value, no purpose. You never know where life will take him.
Dr. Nadine Leachman.
On behalf of the graduating class, I thank you for sharing your story of resilience and your words of encouragement to us. We aspire and will work hard to represent this noble institution. Thank you. God's continued blessing and guidance always.
A very good afternoon to our board chairman, principal, vice principal, teachers, distinguished guests, and graduates. I would like to say that I am very honored to have been given this opportunity to bid farewell to my class 11C. You were my first form class here at Roger Clark High, and you didn't disappoint. You were helpful, funny, creative, passionate, and respectful. Moving forward, I want you to continue on this path. Remember to offer a helping hand where needed. Continue to incorporate humor in your lives, because laughter is indeed the best medicine. Continue to always find creative and innovative ways to express yourselves. Be respectful, because respect will carry you through life. In everything 11C, put God first. Remember, He promised in His Word in Jeremiah 29, verse 11, and I quote, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future," end quote. I want to wish you a bright future. I know that success does not come by wishful thinking, but through hard work. All the best, guys. I love you.
All right, good afternoon, education officers, members of school board, principal, vice principal, and staff of the Roger Clark High School. Parents, well-wishers, graduates, welcome to our graduation ceremony 2021. Today, I stand before you consumed with emotion as I reminisce on the past 2 years. The happy times we share, the numerous challenges we face, which we have had to overcome of class of 11S. I must say it was an amazing journey. At the beginning of our journey in grade 10, as expected, you were rowdy and took a while to settle down as you were placed in class with many familiar faces. It was a joy to see you happy and interacting with each other, but this did not last long due to the spread of the coronavirus, which caused an abrupt end to our face-to-face interaction. As we go online, it resulted in many challenges. But as a form teacher in grade 11, Mr. Smith and I ensured that the form class was your home away from home. We guided you actively, listened to your concern and insecurities, and comfort you while giving academic, personal and professional guidance. Mr. Smith and I did our very best to provide a safe and comfortable environment while motivating you to be the best you can be and strive to achieve your life goal. Parents, teachers, well-wishers, thank you for taking the time out today to join us in celebrating the achievement of the graduating class of 2021. Students, I encourage you to never give up. Strive toward your dream. Never let anything or anyone hold you back from achieving them. 11S students, I look forward with great anticipation of the lives you will build yourself as a product of Roger Clarke High School, the home of real champions. Graduates, step out, be proud, and remember that perseverance conquers everything.
It is a privilege of mine to be the one to pray for these graduates. And so let's look to God on their behalf. Father, we thank you so much for all that you have done for us. We thank you, God, that you have given us life. We thank you, God, that we have the opportunity to experience such a day as this. Lord, I come to you on behalf of some young people today that are exuberantly poising themselves now for the future, I believe. God, we know, you know, I know, God, that they cannot do anything really for themselves and be successful. But God, when the righteous man comes to you, we know, God, that you can effect a change in the future. And so, God, I come to you today on their behalf because, God, I'm asking you a simple request. I request, God, that you will guide them. That you will open doors, Lord, for them to go through. That, God, you will show them the direction in which they should take. I pray, God, that every day that they live, every moment that they are awake, Lord, their actions will be leading them to achieve their goals. That, Father, they will be so focused on achieving, God, that there will be no time for idle jesting, for playing small, for wasting time. But, God, everything that they do will be poising them in a position that they will have a great future. And so, God, as they venture outside the walls of the Roger Clarke High School, I ask today that you will have your hands on their lives. That, Father, you will lead them into their next step. So we'll be moving on to higher education. So we'll be moving on into the workplace. So we'll be moving on into different eras, oh God, different ventures of their lives, trying to achieve their goals. But Father, I pray that you will help them to understand that I can do all things through Jesus Christ. Help them to understand as the words of the wise man who says, trust in the Lord. Be not, O God, so self-confident in what you can do, but believe God to lead you into the right future. Don't lean on their own understanding, but in all your ways, they will acknowledge you, God, as their God. And as you lead them, Lord, I pray, God, that they will have a prosperous life. That, God, they will have it to show to the generation of tomorrow that the actions that they accomplished today gave them and led them into the future that they are in tomorrow. God, I pray that you preserve them. Let them have that vitality, that sustainability, God, that will help them to understand that 1,000 miles begins with one step. Thank you today, Lord. Thank you for their lives. Thank you for what you have accomplished already in this institution, so God, that they can go out with a knowledge, with an understanding, and with wisdom, knowing, Lord, that they now need to trump the next hurdle. And so I thank you, Lord, again for them. Remember their parents, remember their associates, remember the positive influences that they will have in their lives. And I ask, God, that when it's all said and done, they will impact the world to come. We thank you now, my King. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Thank you.
On behalf of the Board of Governors at the Roger Clarke High School, I want to thank you all for participating in, tuning in, and viewing our first virtual graduation in the year 2021. We thank you so much for your support throughout the school year 2020-2021, and we look forward to your continued support in the year 2021-2022. Thank you and God bless you.
Today's graduation ceremony signifies another milestone for our graduates. It proved you have stood the test of time and persevered to the end. I congratulate you on your success and resilience. As you go into the world of the unknown possibilities, remember these. Let your dreams be bigger than your fears, and your actions louder than your words. And if opportunity does not knock, build a door and invite opportunity to knock. Thank you for being here today, and thanks for watching our YouTube channel.
Eternal Father, bless our land. Guard us with thy mighty hand. Keep us free from evil powers. Be our light through countless hours. To our leaders, great defender, grant true wisdom from above. Justice, truth be ours forever, Jamaica. Jamaica, Jamaica, land we love. Teach us true respect for all. Stir response to duty's call. Strengthen us, the weak to change. Give us vision lest we perish. knowledge centers. Heavenly Father, grant true wisdom from above. Justice, truth be us forever, Jamaica land we love, Jamaica.